Welcome to video number 3 of our Unit 2 on Bonding video series, where we take a look at a different way that atoms will chemically bond to one another, known as covalent bonding. Before we do this, I want to recap some things from the last video where we talked about ionic bonding. What we saw was that when an ionic bond forms between two atoms, electrons are actually transferred from one atom, the metal, to another atom, the nonmetal, creating what we called a cation and an anion. Let's take a look again at how this works with our very unhappy, very chemically unstable lithium and fluorine atoms. What we saw was if lithium could transfer its outermost valence to the fluorine, that would make lithium much happier, because now lithium actually does have the same configuration as a noble gas. Fluorine now also has the configuration of a noble gas, making it happy and chemically stable. Even more important is how these atoms change. They both become charged. Lithium, the positive cation, fluorine, the negative anion, and as Coulomb's law tells us, these opposite charged particles will attract to one another. That attraction is the ionic bond. Today, however, we're going to look at how atoms do this a different way, known as covalent bonding. In covalent bonding, you're going to see how electrons are shared between two atoms, both of which are nonmetals, and we form a new particle called a molecule. To look at how this works, we're going to use F2 as an example. F2 is the fluorine molecule, of course. We're going to look at this process two ways. One way down here with a somewhat more realistic model of two fluorine atoms, and up top with simply the electron dot diagrams, because that's a little bit easier to follow. Both processes are the same. Here we go. The best way to imagine this is to think about the two atoms getting closer and closer together until at some point they're so close that they can actually share a pair of electrons between the two. Out of that shared pair, one electron came from each atom. You can see that happening there. This shared pair in red, which we actually call a shared pair of electrons, is really important, because now if you imagine how many electrons each fluorine has access to, this fluorine now has 8 electrons. That is a noble gas configuration. That's a satisfied octet. Same thing for the fluorine on the right. And as always, the point of this satisfied octet is both atoms are now chemically stable with noble gas configurations. Normally when we draw these, we don't represent that shared pair of electrons with two big red dots. It's usually with a single straight line. That straight line is called a single covalent bond. It's also worth mentioning that what we've drawn right here is called a Lewis dot structure. So we have now the Lewis dot structure for F2 with a single covalent bond. We're going to look at two more examples of how this happens. First, with the oxygen molecule O2, of course, using two oxygen atoms, each oxygen has 6 valence. That's not an octet. However, if they move close enough together to share electrons, they can actually share 2 pairs, creating what we call a double covalent bond. For our final example, with N2, the nitrogen molecule, we use 2 nitrogen atoms, both of which have 5 valence. They move close enough together to actually share 3 pairs, creating what's called a triple covalent bond. Triple covalents are the largest of our covalent bond types. If you're wondering why not a quadruple, why stop with 3? There's simply not enough room between the two atoms to create a quadruple covalent bond. So that concludes our introductory video to covalent bonding. Please enjoy the recap to follow.